Hey guys, so in this video, we'll be going over gems and equipment. Before we get started, if you're a fan of King of Avalon videos and content, please take a minute to click like on this video. If you haven't already, click subscribe and click the notification bell to be notified that when the next video is released. Both gems and equipment can be found here in the forge. For gems, click the gemstone armory. It will list out all of the gems that you have applied. All right, you can click the craft gemstones tab. And within this tab, if you have the previous rank gem, you can use that plus some of the books here, the tomes, to create your gem. Gemstones are divided up into attack, defense, health, and troop stats. You have two troop stat gems. You have six health gems, you have six defense gems, and you have four attack gems. So what you'll see with gemstones is that your defense and your health have a lot more weight than your troop and attack gems. Specifically, for this ranking, for rank six, which is the Dream Jewel, you get, for troops, you can get a max with all gems combined, which are two. You can get a max of 92.6 troop attack, defense, troop defense, and troop health. For health stats, which is your bowman health, infantry health, cav health, you can get a max of 555.6. Same goes with your defense, which is the cav, bow, and infantry defense. And with attack, you can get up to 370.4 stats for your bow attack, infantry attack, and cav attack. You can get those by upgrading, by enhancing your gems. You start off with, for example, on your attack, you start off with 56.5 attack, then you go to 58, then you go to 63, then you can go to 72, then 81, and finally 92.6. Multiply that times 4, and you get 370.4. For the troop stats, you can start with 28.2, then you go to, and then you go to 29.3, then 31.9, 36, 40, and 46. There's only two of them, so if you double that, you end up with 92.6. Of all of the different things that you can get in the game, different items that you can get, as far as troop attack, troop stats, of all the items that you can get in the game and upgrade, for the troop stats, gems are one of the lowest. As far as attack stats, it's pretty much on average a little bit higher than what you would get for equipment, but lower than what you would get for the same level hero weapons. For health, though, it's at the very top. The 555.6 that you can get for your health and your defense are much higher than what you can get from equipment or hero weapons. And even higher than what you can get from hero weapons. Now let's take a look at equipment. Equipment is pretty much the opposite of gems, and that's why they work well together. So for equipment, you get high troop stats and low to medium everything else. Within the armory, you can click the magnifying glass next to your item here, next to your equipment piece, and you can go starting with zero, which is the first level for equipment, and you can click the arrow to see the way that it goes. Each piece of equipment has different, four different stats on them for a total of 24 stats, which you have from troop stats all the way down to your health stats for bow. So if you go through here, you'll see you go from, for example, on the troop stat here, which is troop health for your chest, you start at 90.2, 93, 101, 115, 130, 150. You can see your troop stat is actually higher than your middle stat, which is the opposite of what you'll see in any other place within King of Avalon. So same thing, if you go down to your boots, you have troop health, you click the magnifying glass, and you can see you go from 90 up to 150. Same thing, you go to your sword and you have troop defense. It goes from 90 to 150. So the totals for equipment are 301.2 for your troop stats, which is your troop attack, troop defense, troop health, and 292.4 for all other stats. If you get all of these maxed out, that's what equipment would give to you, what your Flamebringer set specifically would give to you. So you'll see this pattern, you know, as we go up to rank 7, rank 8, rank 9, rank 10, it doesn't matter. You'll see the same pattern where the troop stats will end up being higher than the middle stats. So when we're talking about equipment statistics, one thing you have to keep in mind are the bonus benefits that you get for having sets. And sometimes you can have different levels of sets. So you can have two of the Flamebringer with some Ice Lord, bring those together, and you still get the benefits. It works in some cases above a certain level and below another level. So these are the current benefits that you get from Flamebringer. You get plus damage and negative damage received. They're super critical. These are the most important stats in the game, and you don't want to talk about equipment without mentioning the damage modifying set bonuses that you get. One of the things that I really like about equipment and your gem stats is you can get both from your with the knight on the lake, the boat. You can get your equipment up to rank 6 once you get the hero weapons, rank 6 hero weapons. You'll be offered the rank 6 equipment here on the boat, so you can roll for a chance to get some Flamebringer. So that's great. And we will be getting emblems shortly, and when we do that, we should then be able to get the rank 6 gem tomes and the materials to make the gems. So I really like that aspect of it, to make it relatively inexpensive to get and rank up your gear and your gems. Gems are relatively cheap compared to other things, and I like the way that they're divided up into 24 different pieces. it makes it a lot easier to get, you know, one or two at a time and not break the bank. For equipment, if you try to rank it up very high, it gets super expensive. Use the boat as much as you possibly can. I would say that both gems and equipment materials, at least, come fairly frequently in rewards for events. So take advantage of that as much as you can to maximize the amount of free and quick through events rather than enhancing them, especially because we're nowhere near the end game when it comes to equipment and gems. So take your time. As you can see, I haven't maxed out this. There's no reason to. I take it as far as I can before, you know, I start having to pay. So then I will just wait. And when things go on sale, I'll do that. Otherwise, I will do what I can just by playing the game. All right. And that's the video that I have for gems and equipment. Again, the next video that you'll see really soon, it will be heroes and hero weapons. Thank you.